this is Stephanie, and this is Talk Tales and Trivia, the show where I talk about society, culture, pop culture, and I give you a little trivia too, so that you can stump your family and friends. It is so cool and a lot of fun. If you are a new listener here at Talk Tales and Trivia, I want to welcome you and thank you so much for tuning in. I hope that you enjoy this episode. So now everybody, get your favorite drink, gather around, sit down in that cozy chair, listen, relax, and enjoy this episode on doing the most good. I'll start with a quote. What is the essence of life? To serve others and to do good. That is from Aristotle. In this episode, I want to talk about doing good, and I want to talk about an organization that is doing good, and maybe perhaps we're missing the whole part about doing good for others. So I hope that you enjoy this episode. Well, the Salvation Army is dedicated to doing a lot of different things to do good for others in need, and that is what we're going to talk about today. Well, the Salvation Army is a Christian organization, but you know what? It doesn't matter because they are doing good for everybody. This organization will take any person under their wing and help that person who needs it. Going to the Salvation Army website, you can find that the organization gives so much to the needy. The Salvation Army is one of the largest organizations that provide help and relief for people within the LGBTQ community. And inclusion is huge. If you have a need, no matter what it is, the Salvation Army is there. No exceptions. Here are just a few services that they give. Homeless shelters. Each of the homeless shelters have transitional housing services, permanent supportive housing services, and reentry resources. They are all available to anyone in need, regardless of race, gender, ethnicity, or sexual orientation. Period. How about drug addiction, disaster relief, food pantries, domestic abuse, veteran services, job training, and help for the aging population? That's just a little bit of what the Salvation Army does. Well, the Salvation Army approximately gives assistance to over 23 million people in America annually and serves 130 countries around the globe. And that's a lot of countries and a lot of people. And what about the COVID-19 poverty? As millions continue to struggle, the help that the Salvation Army gives is so wonderful. They help families make rent, pay bills, buy groceries, and survive the pandemic life that we are in right now. Now, I, of course, have a story, a tale, if you will, of my Salvation Army life. Well, my story of the Salvation Army begins in 1990. I wasn't ready to leave the city after living there for 3 years. Well, the Salvation Army Hotel for Women came in when I needed it the most. Well, back in 1990, it was on 19th Street across from Gramercy Park. What more beautiful a space could there be? It was close to work and not bad accommodations, if I have to say so myself. It was then a whopping, are you sitting down? $472 a month, which included a shared bathroom with three other women who I never saw, breakfast and dinner, full laundry facilities, all within a protected doorman building. Back then, it was pretty cool to say that you lived in a wonderful building. But now, it's ultra cool. There's no doubt the Hotel for Women has changed. Well, first of all, it's not a hotel for women anymore. Well, it is still owned by the Salvation Army, but it is not called the Hotel for Women anymore. It is called the Markle. A matter of fact, unlike when I lived there, it looks more like a building of really cool condos that fit right into the swanky New York City neighborhood. Well, the Markle is for 18 to 55-year-olds, but they do have a building in a beautiful area of Harlem called Eastview Residence, and that is for 55 plus. Now go to either one of those websites and take a look and tell me that they are not remarkable. Like everything, there is a history to the Salvation Army. And quick sidebar here. This reminds me of an episode I did about 2 years ago about the founder of the YMCA. Well, the YMCA was founded on June 6th in 1844 by Sir George Williams in London, originally as a Young Men's Christian Association and aiming to put Christian principles into practice by developing a healthy body, mind, spirit. Well, it's funny to note that the Salvation Army started kind of the same way, and around the same time. It all started with William Booth. Well, William Booth began the Salvation Army in 1865 as a means to help the suffering souls throughout London who were not willing to attend or even welcome to attend a traditional church. Soon after, he began his ministry in England. In 1852, William Booth abandoned the concept of the traditional church and took the gospel directly to the people, much like Sir George Williams that started the YMCA. Walking the streets of London, he preached to the poor, the homeless, the hungry, and the destitute. Well, back then, the organization operated under the name of the Christian Mission and had over 1,000 volunteers. They were mostly thieves, prostitutes, gamblers, and drunkards that were amongst their first converts to the Christian organization. And soon, those converts were also preaching and singing in the streets as living testimonies to the power of God. After a while, William Booth and his organization was thought of as kind of a volunteer army. But eventually, William Booth thought of calling it something even better than the volunteer army. How about the Salvation Army? Today, the Salvation Army is active in virtually every corner of the world, offering healing and hope to all those in need. Well, the COVID-19 pandemic has called for help from a lot of people, and there is a story of hope. Well, Northern Virginia Adult Rehabilitation Center, where the Salvation Army has its national headquarters, receives mass COVID-19 vaccinations. Because the Salvation Army is willing and able to offer residential treatment, it is essential that beneficiaries and staff are vigilant to prevent an outbreak of COVID-19. 1 year after the start of the COVID-19 pandemic, the Salvation Army will continue to do the most good for everybody that is in need. The nation's largest social services organization remains committed to meeting urgent need while setting its eyes on addressing pandemic poverty. And there are other organizations and corporations that have come to the need and helped the Salvation Army. AT&T contributes nearly $1 million in PPE to the Salvation Army for frontline workers to support its ongoing COVID-19 relief efforts. And the donations come at a critical time of need. And did you know that astronaut, the great Buzz Aldrin, makes significant donations to the Salvation Army on a regular basis? We've all seen the red kettle Santa Clauses on almost every street corner at Christmas, ringing their bell for donations. Well, this Christmas, fewer iconic red kettles combined with less disposable income among donors made traditional fundraising efforts for the country's largest social services provider seemingly impossible for the Christmas 2020 year. But then came the support of the Christmas Red Kettle campaign. More than $14 million from various stores across the country gave to the Christmas Red Kettle campaign. And in the Wall Street Journal recently, I found that the Salvation Army has helped 155% more people with Christmas assistance across the country than any other year. And in the PRN Newswire, I found this: 2020 proves no match for Americans' generosity. Yes, it's true. Donors did step up to rescue Christmas with the Salvation Army. donors answered the call to rescue Christmas by increasing giving through online and in-home channels. Thanks to the generous support of the American public, contributions to the Salvation Army during the 2020 holiday campaign increased 27% year over year, raising more than $557.3 million in much-needed funding. Yes, indeed, the Salvation Army is most known for getting those much-needed items in the hands of those that are so much in need. For me, in the past years, I have given new and gently used furniture, clothing, and monetary donations, remembering how the Salvation Army was there for me in my time of need back in 1990. And it's true, sometimes we all need help. And most of us know that hard times and disaster is a time that the Salvation Army is needed the most. It is reported that 59% of people prefer help and support from a religious counselor or clergy member. And that, too, is where the Salvation Army comes in. Well, the Salvation Army is serving all without discrimination, and that is so cool. Overall, the Salvation Army provides programs and services to those seeking help in any way, at every age, and in every area of their life. The Salvation Army is committed to accommodating all those in need without unlawful discrimination or harassment. This is indeed a worldwide staple that we must never forget about. I just am willing to bet, that the founder, William Booth, back in his day, had no idea how much of an impact the Salvation Army would have in today's world. So turn our passion, your passion, my passion, into action. Educate and inspire change. And remember what Aristotle said. What is the essence of life? To serve others and to do good. Hey, if you've enjoyed this episode of Talk Tales and Trivia, that's great, and I love that. You can email me, talktalesandtrivia@gmail.com is my email address. Go to talktalesandtrivia.com to get to all my episodes, my show notes, and guess what? There's a little bio on me if you're wondering what I'm all about. Also, go to growinguncomfortable.com to listen to my second podcast, get to all the episodes, my show notes, and that bio on me is there if you're wondering what I'm all about. Also, email me, growinguncomfortable@gmail.com. There is one more thing I have to tell you. If you subscribe to Talk Tales and Trivia and Growing Uncomfortable, you will get the notifications of when new episodes come out, and that is so cool. I hope that you have enjoyed this episode of Talk Tales and Trivia, and I'll catch you later. Okay, bye-bye.